So what is your pirate name?
They call me Mr. Cutter.
Mr. Cutter. And what position do you have on the pirate crew?
I'm the ship surgeon of Blackbeard's crew.
Blackbeard's crew. Mm-hmm. Let me take a look at your tools. Maybe explain these tools to me.
All right. Well, these are the tools that would be used to treat the various ailments of the sailors on board ship. When you're at sea, there's no possibility of running into port to take somebody to the infirmary. So hopefully there's somebody aboard that can deal with the situation. And so I've got equipment here to do everything from surgery to removing bullets and other kind of shrapnel.
Okay.
And then on the other table we have a small drug laboratory.
What's the most common ailment on board a ship?
The most common ailment, believe it or not, was constipation.
What was the solution?
An enema.
Enema, okay. Mm-hmm. Do you have a tool for that here?
Or using a jalap or some other laxative.
Okay. What kind of surgeries do you have to perform as a surgeon on the ship?
Well, everything, like I said, from amputation, full-on amputation, to minor cuts and whatnot.
Can you kind of give me the process and exactly how you would start the amputation? Do you have the tools here with you?
I do.
Show me.
You would start the amputation by giving a little bit of laudanum. This is opium dissolved in alcohol.
Opium and alcohol.
Huh?
And would they still be conscious?
Oh, no, of course.
Yeah.
It would numb.
Yeah.
It would make them a little drowsy. Make it a little easier to deal with the pain. But they were not going to be anesthetized the way we think of it today. Most of these surgeries, particularly limb surgery, was done in 3 to 5 minutes, so hopefully you could endure that long.
So you would give them that to help take away some of the pain,
right,
and then what was next?
Then the tourniquet.
Tourniquet
would be placed to slow or stop the blood flow.
Okay, now the screw. Explain the screws on there.
All right, the screw tourniquet allows, well, see, it's got the belt for the rings for tightening.
Right.
Around the limb. And then you have a screw so you can place pressure on a specific artery.
Right.
Rather than on the entire limb.
Right. And then what was next?
Next, you would hold the patient down and maybe give him a small drink of alcohol to make sure he was not going to pass out. He put a bite stick in his mouth so he won't bite his tongue.
What is that covered with? Leather?
Leather.
Okay.
Yeah.
And that's so he wouldn't bite his tongue?
Yeah, wouldn't bite his tongue.
Did you have any instances on the ship where somebody actually did bite their tongue?
Oh, yes, of course.
Yeah, it was a common problem.
Right.
What would happen after they bit their tongue?
Well, hopefully the tongue would heal by itself. We can actually stitch the tongue up.
Okay, so that's what you got there?
If necessary.
Yeah, okay.
But, once the tourniquet was in place, you would start with a capital knife, and just above where the wound or break was, you would cut through the skin, pull that back like a sleeve, and about a half an inch up, you'd cut through the muscle. all the way to the boat.
Right.
Pull that back. Right. It exposed the bone. Use the bone saw to cut the bone and expose the limb. And then allow the muscle to fall back over the end of the bone. Maybe put a stitch or two in it to hold it together. And then pull the skin down. Maybe fold it over. You might run a stitch or two between them. Then you use a linen bandage to wrap it up. And
how long would it take them to heal, Captain Cutter?
Usually about 6 to 8 weeks, depending on their nutrition.
Yeah. Did you watch them the whole time?
Oh yeah, of course.
Yeah.
Of course.
How often? Were injuries a common problem, of course, after a battle? I guess you very, very busy after a battle.
Yes, you would be. But day to day, you had your run-of-the-mill stomach problems. You could slip on a wet deck and break an arm or a leg. If you were up working the rigging, fall out of the rigging and crush an elbow or shoulder.
So it's very, very dangerous being on the ship.
Yeah, being on a sailing ship was akin to being in prison as far as space went.
And you were very secluded.
But you stood a chance of drowning or getting seriously injured.
Did the crew members fight amongst themselves a lot?
They did, but the quartermaster broke it up very quickly.
Now, the quartermaster was second to the captain.
Right.
Right.
The quartermaster was second in command on a pirate ship. Now, on a Navy ship or a merchant vessel, he was a little further down the pecking order. But on a pirate ship, he was the spokesman.
Now, as far as you getting paid, were you paid higher than the other men?
Yeah, I usually got a share and maybe a share and a quarter of whatever was captured.
Why did Blackbeard blockade Charleston?
If you look down there on that table, you see a pewter syringe.
Pewter syringe. Okay, let me go take a look at that. This pewter syringe right here.
Exactly.
Okay.
That is an exact replica of a syringe that they found on the Queen Anne's Revenge.
Okay.
Down in Beaufort. That is a urethral syringe used to treat STDs.
Okay.
With mercury ointment.
So it's pretty well known in history that he had syphilis, or at least it was very common.
It was probably... That's the indication.
And it's very common in those times.
Oh, yes. Very.
Yeah.
Particularly since he'd been in the tropics where syphilis is even more prevalent.
Right. Okay.